everybody. Welcome to the show. It's cold outside, so let's get to it. The hardest language to translate. So here are the top 10 foreign language. I think it's the toughest to translate. And the translator is a tough job. I'm serious, it can be time consuming, it's complex. As companies go international, learning different cultures plays a big role when translating other language too. So let's start with number 10. Number 10, Icelandic. It's an old Viking language. It may be Germanic language related to English, but seems surprising to some, Icelandic is an old classic language. The vocabulary is so old, archaic, that a lot of English words are not equivalent to Icelandic. It has been unchanged since the Viking Age. If you understand Icelandic, you travel back to the Viking Age, you can speak to Vikings in Icelandic, they understand you. Interesting. Rather than adopting a foreign words, they create their own Icelandic words when new ideas or concepts come in. Number 9, Hungarian. Ooh, it's a tough one. It has 26 cases. Ouch. The grammar is so crazy. The rules of grammar is insane. That it depends on the word, several endings. There are so many endings. There are subtle cultural elements that make it harder to translate. So for tourists travel to Hungarian, don't worry. Especially if you travel to Budapest, the second best get, I don't know how to pronounce the third largest industry name in Hungary. I hope I pronounced it right. Number 8. When you travel to Hungary, don't worry, most of them can speak English. Just like Hungarian, Finnish has a crazy grammar. Let's take a look at an example. The phrase like, I like you. In English, it's simple. Just place it as one word after the other. While in Finnish, there's many steps with it. In Finnish, to translate that, you say, minä pidän sinusta. I hope I pronounced the Finnish phrase right. It's considered wrong because it has to be translated into Finnish. You need to understand the difference between how the verb is conjugated, how the adverb or noun is affected by consonant radiation, and it requires the elective case, which does not exist in Indo-European language, the elective case. It sounds more accurate, something like Maki kan susta. Number 7, Hebrew. It's an old ancient language but tough to translate. It's written just like Arabic, it's written from right to left. The grammar, it has grammar and many new sounds. Number 6, Polish. There are many sounds, consonants, like chloroplasm and bismikliny. I hope I pronounced it right. I have several meanings. It's a pretty low context language and it's hard to pronounce. The grammar are so complex that there are a lot more exceptions than there is to regular rules. Special letters make it harder. Changes of special letters can change its meaning. I heard stories about the translator in in late 70s or early 80s to translate to the Polish people about the solidarity in 1981, workers' unions' rights. I don't know the full history of it, and they once translator make a mistake, they mistranslation that into a big disaster. He translated as, "I like to touch Buddhist private parts." He didn't mean to translate it that way. The real translation, I think, he meant to say is, "I would like to be in touch with Polish students about the life in communist Poland and the Eastern Europe also." Anyways, moving on to number 5. Japanese, it has thousands of characters, kanji that provides different meaning. Sentence structure and grammar is completely different. Japanese is a high context language, which has many meanings. Translating from Japanese to English takes a lot of steps than any other language. When translating to Japanese, they got to break down smaller Japanese phrase and find them specific true meaning. To become a translator in Japanese, you've got to have 4 graphs of Japanese. You've got to know as much as you can, which is the 1% which voice in Japanese for the Westerners. Number 4, Korean. The grammar are similar to Japanese. It has a lot of wacky translation. For example, jujok palita literally losing face to face. It actually means I'm embarrassed. Ut jujima literally means don't make me laugh. It means stop kidding around. Call Madgada, taste like honey. Accepted meaning is I'm so happy. And finally, for example, Yil Mut Medkoda literally means you ate water, but accepted meaning is you're screwed, you messed up. Number 3. Move on to number 3, Thai. It has 44 consonants and 18 vowels, 62 sounds. All letters are the same. No lower or neither uppercase, no space between the separate words. It does not end here. They use Cambodian script, which is difficult because adjective and adverbs are hard to identify. There are no spaces between separate words. And again, there's only one single case, no lower and upper case. There are special forms to communicate with you. Talk about religion or with addressing, talking to the religious people, monks, or with religious situation, I should say. So Thai is also the hard language to both learn and translate. Number 2, Arabic. There are numerous number of dialects, make it hard to translate. There are a wide range of different vocabulary that makes it hard to understand. One word has many meanings. Meaning from right to left, and which added complication. The dialectal influence is location-based. Translator must pick up the right word for Arabic because it's very high contextual. Single concept can describe many meaning, a lot of meaning. And don't forget, when writing Arabic script, small changes of script can make a big difference and change the meaning. Number 1, Mandarin and the Chinese variety of Chinese language. It is also the mind-blocking that over 80,000 some that first made about 100,000 characters. It's a total language. Most of the words have multiple many meanings. They require high expositive and creative skills to find the true meaning of the document that would fit the purpose of the content that will make it sound natural. The translator must always know as much context as possible in order to translate the Mandarin. So that's it for today. So what I'm trying to say is not all languages are created equal. When you're using Google Translator, don't trust the translator on all language, because when you translate it, for example, Korean to English, like I said, they only give you a literal phrase or literal meaning. You got to rely on native speakers to fully understand the language. So when you try to learn other language, you got to practice with the native speaker. So don't trust anything on the translator. So I hope you all have a good one. And by the way, I just got a new camera. I filmed it with a new one. So don't forget to like and subscribe to my channel, SFA Production. So don't forget to comment on what's the another hardest language to learn translate. So cheers.